Well, tomorrow is International Burger Day. You're excited, aren't you?
Oh, I tell you, every day should be Burger Day.
Me too. And to celebrate, we've brought in the self-proclaimed TikTok Burger King who can make a killer Aussie burger.
Aussie burger.
All right, what do we tell them?
All right, then. Give me a home among the gum trees with lots of palm trees. A sheep or two, a kangaroo, a clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair.
Whoa. There we go, huh? With over 27 million likes, Ali Chobani Ochebo is my new best mate. He went from a business major to owning a burger joint, and he joins us now in the studio. Thanks for coming.
Hey, legend.
Thanks for having me.
Nice to see you.
With burgers this good, why wait till tomorrow? Why do you love burgers so much?
The burger has something in it for everyone. I mean,
I'm with you.
Everyone's happy eating burgers. Every time it's family burger night, everyone's happy. I mean, there's always a burger for there for people without cheese, without sauce. You can have whatever you want, dress it however way you want. Yeah, it's just the people.
There's more to say about that, is it? It's the people.
I've never met a burger I didn't like. I think you're right there. You're known as the self-proclaimed burger king on TikTok, and you're going to cook us some of your best burgers today. Yeah. Where do we start?
Okay,
you like to keep it simple too in this one, don't you?
Simple, simple. We've got pickles and onions here.
We did see like a little bit of beetroot, a little bit of pineapple on that big kind of towel, and I thought, oh, I don't know.
Look, we're keeping it fancy today. I'm going to show you guys how to create the perfect smash burger. So you guys know what a smash burger is?
Yeah, let's get in it.
What is the secret to the perfect burger?
The smash, which I'm going to show you right now. So Tristan, if you could give me a hand here.
Is it just plain beef mince with anything in it?
Plain beef mince. So people ask me often on Instagram, do I put in breadcrumbs, egg, that kind of thing? I say no, quality fresh beef mince. That's all you need. So what I want you to do is grab it.
Yeah.
What you call this thing?
Burger smasher.
Burger smasher, right?
And I want you to hold a bit lower. Hold for 5 seconds and see if you can get it right. Slowly twist off. Twist and pull away. Yeah. There you go.
All perfect. Right.
Can I buy one of these from your house?
Yeah, you can. I've got them on my website if you want, but perfect smash for a first time. Nice. Going to give it a quick brush of salt. That's a lot.
Yep.
Okay. That's all right.
You can hit it with some pepper if you like as well, but I prefer just salt. And in a way, you're pretty much recreating what goes into a great Wagyu steak. You want a nice brown crust, salt, and that's all you need for the flavour, bringing out that really good fat content.
So now, don't put any egg or anything in there.
None of that. I'd want you to create our special sauce here.
Oh, are you going to give us the recipe?
In a way.
You're going to leave out a special ingredient?
I'll keep some
for me. That's what you should do. Okay.
So we've got around half a cup of mayo there.
Yep.
We've got around a bit more than a tablespoon of ketchup, a bit more than a teaspoon of mustard, and then some gherkin relish.
Do you have to use actual ketchup? Relish. Because ketchup and tomato sauce are different.
They do create a different profile. I prefer the ketchup because it does have a bit of apple cider vinegar in it or vinegar. But honestly, with burger sauces, start off with mayo as the base if you're at home, and you can add whatever you want. You can go for chili.
What's this one again?
Gherkin relish.
Gherkin relish.
Ooh.
Yeah, so that's going to give it a bit of crunch and a bit of acidity.
It's like a dream job. How do you become the CEO of burgers online?
Pretty much just sharing everything that I love about burgers. I mean, people resonated with that so much. They will see me making the burgers and see the genuine smile, me eating the burgers.
Yeah.
People just got on board.
Do I need to flip this or
give it a bit more? So the way we know that it's good to flip is when we see a lot of grey around the edges and a bit of crust.
Yeah.
I'll take care of that. I think we'll give it a bit more.
Pump the heat, huh?
Pump the heat. Oh, and that's really, really important for a good smash patty because you want that nice, deep, rich crust. It's called a Maillard reaction if you're going to get a bit scientific.
Yeah.
But that's going to give it a nice...
Speaking of reactions, I had a good reaction there because I didn't see any salad here.
No salad.
And a burger to me is just meat and then whatever you want to put on it, but no salad. You don't need salad, huh?
Yeah, I find personally it gets a bit soggy. So I've eaten in the past 2 years over, I'd say, 700 burgers.
Oh my gosh.
Working every day.
In one year. That's like two burgers a day.
Yeah, pretty much.
Holy heck.
Not the healthiest, but I do try to keep it.
You look pretty good,
man. You've got everything you need here.
You're great.
Gotta keep it balanced.
Yeah.
But after that many burgers, I figured simple's the best.
Yeah.
So we'll give this one a flip.
You were actually studying business before you decided to get into this.
Bachelor of Accounting, and I knew I'd always wanted to do my own. I'm not sure if you can see there, but nice deep rich crust.
Oh, looks great.
Yes. That's where the flavour is.
It's a really good day. Yeah.
Oh, perfect. So I pretty much always knew I'd wanted to do my own business, but I was following the cold corporate, you know, that path, and I figured, why not just do something on the side, start my own burger business. I planned for it to be once a month.
Yep.
But eventually through COVID, I had figured, hey, why not just take it? And so I started TikTok around the same time I started doing my little side hustle. And you grow from there.
Awesome. Oh, should we build these burgers and really, have really a little taste? Yeah. So
what do you do with the old onions there? Do you cook them or do you kind of...
I prefer them raw.
Yeah, right on.
For a bit of fresh. Okay, so Tristan, you're lucky today. You're going to get a double patty.
Oh, double.
I could tell you were a bit hungry before this.
Well, yes, we had Brussels sprouts.
This is such a great day,
got to make up for it.
Okay. You want to jump in, T?
Special sauce, onions.
Oh, yeah.
And I'll toast these top buns for you.
Oh,
they're called the crown.
Yeah.
So special sauce, onions, pickles.
Yep.
And we'll see who comes up with the best looking burger.
Mate, the best looking burger is the one that's disappeared, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it.
We had a talk about pickles, whether it should go on burger or not.
Pickles all the way.
We got a crown each for us, Dylan.
One
yes, get in there, T.
One crown there. There you go.
There we go. Yeah, that's what you need to see. If you want to see more delicious recipes, you can head to Ali's socials at Chebo's Burgers. Thanks for coming in, buddy. I'm going to get stuck into this as soon as I throw to the break. You are watching Studio 10. More to come. See you in a sec.
Thank you.